term, kind of what were your initial reactions to hearing Coach City mention to you guys yesterday that you were the sixth man of the year? What does that kind of mean to you to be able to contribute so much to this team this year, especially being kind of, was it your fourth year here?
Third
year here, okay. Yeah, just to be able to kind of make that leap this year.
It means a lot, especially, you know, in a program like this where there's so many good players, and coming off of last year and the year before that where I obviously wanted to do more but didn't get that opportunity, you might say. So it felt really good, like, having a big role this year, knowing that I had a lot of freedom on the court to play and really contribute to this team. So it was amazing hearing them say that I won the award.
You mentioned that freedom, especially a lot of athletes coming off the season like you did last year to come to this level. What kind of confidence instilled with you, whether it be the coaching staff or the teammates?
There's so much of it, and I think that's kind of what makes me go. My coach is like they really don't tell me much because they trust me so much with the ball in my hands offensively, and they've told me that before, that, you know, when I have it, they're confident and they know that I can make plays. So even with my teammates, they tell me the exact same thing, and it just gives me so much confidence to do what I know I can when I'm out there.
What's it say about this team that you guys had so many guys earn at least some level of recognition by the league?
It's crazy, because some guys that didn't get awards probably could have too. And it just shows how deep we are, and it shows that, like, at any moment you can bring somebody off the bench or a starter or whoever, that maybe a guy that hasn't played, and they can contribute. Eric helped us do that against Stony Brook and a couple other times with other players. So it's good when you have a team like that where you can play whoever you got.
What has this team fine-tuned over the last couple weeks here?
I think just the small things. You know, we won our conference pretty early, so we didn't really want to get, like, complacent and start playing bad. So we kind of just tried to lock in on defense and get that, like, connectiveness going into the tournament so we could be sharp when that time comes.
What has the vibe been like since it's been a while since you guys have played a game that's really meant anything?
Yeah. It's been good. You know, we've been trying to keep each other up, especially some of the older guys that have been here. You know, they obviously, like, the guys in their last years are kind of like down, like, man, I want to play a game that matters. But just trying to keep their spirits up, knowing that when the time comes, we got to be ready. So it's been good. We haven't been, like, over, like, celebrating and confident about it. We just taking one game at a time and keeping our head down.
I've seen some of your victory duets with Benny on Instagram. what is that relationship like between the two of you?
I love Benny. He's such a great guy. He's been there since my freshman year, super positive, and we joke around a lot, and I think it helps us, especially on the court. The same jokes we say off the court, we say on the court. And it's just fun to have a laugh here and there just to keep the locker room vibes good.
That's NJIT team. You guys have handled them pretty well in your first couple of times about them. What are some things you guys are keeping an eye out to try and make sure that they aren't able to kind of take advantage of lapses and kind of situations like that?
I think for us, we just really got to play our game defensively and offensively, offensively with confidence, and then on the defensive end, just doing what we know how to do best. NJIT is pretty good. They got some good players. I think a couple guys on one of the all-conference teams. So just doing what we know how to do and doing it to our best abilities.
What pressure do you feel at the top seed?
None, honestly. This is where we wanted to be and knew where we should be. So we just got to, like I said, continue to do what we know how to do. So there's not really pressure, I feel like. Just got to go out there and do what we do.
Last year you guys had to sit 2 weeks after your last regular season game and then also didn't have any fans in the building. How nice is it going into a scenario where neither of those is going to be the case this weekend?
It's amazing, and I think it's actually more motivation for us, knowing that last year we didn't have fans. We had a long wait on top of everything we went through with COVID. So I feel like it's a big motivation. It just gives us a plus one going into these games.